Shortly after World War II, European countries felt threatened to the possibility of a nuclear holocaust. The Soviet Union developed nuclear capabilities in 1949, and war seemed imminent. People lived in fear that one day, at the push of a button, nervous leaders would end the world. Civilians protested with signs and demonstrations, while musicians protested and sometimes mocked the nuclear scare. Nina, a German new wave group who wrote and performed 99 Luftballons, and The Clash, an English punk band who played Stop the World, spoke out against the need for nuclear weaponry in their songs. In fact, the city seems to be gone.
Clash, an English punk band, bursted onto the music scene in 1976. On November 28, 1980, The Clash released Stop the World, a song with a strong anti-nuclear message. As seen through the lyrics of the song, the band describes the destruction of a nuclear attack. By describing the desolate city, The Clash show the severe repercussions of nuclear warfare. The Clash's plea reflects the feelings of Europe at the time. Although The Clash objected to nuclear weapons in their music, civilians protested in the streets. In 1957, an organization advocating the disarmament of nuclear weapons in Britain formed. They called themselves the Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament. Since 1953, the Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament has organized an annual march close to Aldermaston in Berkshire, England, to demonstrate their opposition to nuclear weapons.
In 1983, Nina wrote 99 Luftballons in response to the German government's hypothetical overreaction to a possible missile threat. She mocked the government, saying how the balloon blips on military radars caused mass hysteria. This song topped charts all across the globe. This anti-war song accompanied the riots and demonstrations. Youth and adults alike demanded their leaders to ban the bomb. The European Nuclear Disarmament was an activist group that kept up a constant stream of correspondence from various countries, which included a German branch headed by Barbel Boley. The END had many different branches, but they all shared the primary concerns to pursue nuclear disarmament, to oppose the use of depleted uranium in warfare, to oppose the use of food irradiation, and to oppose the widespread use of radiation. The nuclear protests went even deeper than in the warfare. They were determined to go further than just in times of war. In one such instance, a nuclear power plant was to be built in a small German town called Wil around 1971. On February 18, 1975, locals busted onto the scene and soon 30,000 people occupied the Wil site. The plant's construction never went underway, and later the land was turned into a nature preserve. Nuclear protest was a reaction towards a possible 20th century apocalypse. German people's concerns and views were best expressed through physical acts of protest and music. Nina's song, 99 Luftballons, provides proof of a concerned country's disapproval. The world's developing nuclear doctrines and policies would
suffice
no longer.
Although nuclear opposition began in the early 20th century by politicians, citizens saw the harmful effects much later, as nuclear warfare became much more realistic after the United States' atomic bombings of Japan. Many countries post-World War II developed nuclear weapons at the constant fear of being attacked. Citizens of these countries used all forms of media, especially music, in order to show the negative effects of nuclear weapons and to convince leaders and other civilians to stray far away from nuclear development. The protests helped to prevent the superpowers from destroying each other, but the development of nuclear weapons still continued in countries such as India and Pakistan. To this day, the only nuclear attacks were the attacks that occurred in World War II, but the looming fear of a nuclear attack still exists.